Have you noticed that cartoonifying photos has become an increasingly trend on social media lately?
Wow!
Many people are using this new trend to create entertaining and beautiful content that stands out from the crowd. If you're interested in trying this out for yourself, I have a good news today. Midjourney is one of the AI-powered tools most used to create this type of content. And in this video, we are going to see together how to use Midjourney to transform your own photos into cartoons, so you can create some fun and truly eye-catching photos as well. Whether you are an artist, a social media influencer, or just looking for a new way to express yourself, Midjourney is an incredibly powerful AI tool that can help you achieve your creative vision. So this is the main interface, and the first thing we need to do is to activate the remix mode. For who doesn't know, the remix mode is amazing. When you generate an image with Midjourney, usually if you don't have the remix mode, you cannot change the original prompt, but with the remix mode, you can. So it's amazing. How can we activate that? Well, there are two options. There is a very simple one, which is typing settings, press enter, and then here you have different options you can change. And what we want is to have this in green, remix mode. To deactivate it, we just press again and it's gonna be deactivated. Obviously, we want to activate it. The second option is to go in the text box and type profile remix and press enter, and remix mode turned on. Perfect. And it's also telling you clicking the variation buttons will now give you a chance to edit your prompt. Amazing. Okay, so now that we've done with the first step, the second step is to upload your image. I picked one of my pictures of when I was in New York, and to upload that on Midjourney, I just need to press on this little button here, the plus button, upload a file, and then I can upload my image, just choosing it. Here you go. And then I press enter again. I think you cannot upload an image bigger than 8 megabytes, by the way. Anyway, so this is my picture. So now what I wanna do, I just click on the picture, right click on it, and then copy link. Easy. We go back on our text box and we type imagine, and you will see that the prompt will open as usual. And then you paste the link you just copied and you type what you would like to have. So in my case, I would like to have my face to be like cartoonified. So what I'm going to add is S cartoon style and press enter. I will start with a very small prompt and then we'll see what happens and in case we'll change it. But with Midjourney, we usually have to run more than once and change the prompt to have what we really want. I think that I've used the slow one, which is not good. Okay, I didn't realize I have a very high quality and a very high style, so I'm gonna just stop this running. So what I have to do, I'll just go onto other reaction, I will look for an X, and then tuck, it will stop. I will change my setting again to be base quality, style medium, and fast mode, otherwise it's gonna be too slow, and then I will run it again. Yes, cartoon style. So this shouldn't take that long. Hopefully. So this is what I got as the first attempt. It's not amazing, I would say, but it gives you the idea of being a cartoon, of course. The background is amazing, like it's New York, you can really tell. And I can tell that there is also something about me, maybe the eyes, I don't know. But with Midjourney, but even with all the others, image generator tools, you don't get the best results at the first attempt. You need to try and rerun the prompt many times, maybe adding or changing details. And also in this case, my first output wasn't very good. What we can do now, we have two options. The first one is to rerun the same prompt by clicking this button here. Otherwise, we can choose one of these pictures. For example, I'm quite happy with picture number one because I think it's the most similar to my original picture, so I can pick that. And with the remix mode, we can change the prompt description we used initially to add more details. So we can press this V1, you will see that the color will change to green. Usually when you click on V1 without the remix mode, it turns blue. In this case, it turns green. This remix prompt will open, and this is your original prompt. You see, this is the link I pasted before, and this is what I wrote, cartoon style. So now, instead of cartoon style, I can maybe specify that I would like to have a white hat and I would like to have a white jumper. So maybe I can write something as a brunette female cartoon face with a white hat and jumper. And then we press submit. Wow, this is what I got from changing our prompt description. It's still not perfect, but it's getting closer to my original picture, and I'm super happy about this. So if I'm happy with, I don't know, number 3, for example, I can take that again and I can keep changing my prompt description to adjust it and to make it nicer. Or I can also use Photoshop. That was very quick, and that's it for today. Hope you enjoyed, and see you soon. Bye.